Okay, ladies and gentlemen, are we ready to get started? Okay, my name is Lou. I'm the commander of Cantigny Post 367. Same guy that was here last year. Appreciate seeing you again. I want to make a few announcements. You know, I'm old, I'm forgetful. You know, some of you young people will understand that when you get older. I see several dignitaries here tonight. Mr. Mayor Bob Odekirk. Hi, Bob. Pat Mudrin, councilman. Larry Hug, councilman. Jan Quinlan, you're out here, right? I swear I saw you. Okay. Did I miss anybody on the city? Oh, Joe, my neighbor, for Christ's sake. Hi, Joe, how are you? Also like to recognize one of our local businessmen that are here, Terry Darcy. Before we get started, I'm sorry, Larry, I can't hear you. County executive. I'm sorry, sir. What's your name?
Jennifer Bertino.
What's that?
Jennifer Bertino.
Jennifer Bertino? Okay.
Sherry Reardon
is here. Where are you, Sherry? That way I'll remember you. Thank you. All right, before we get started, I want to do this. It's not really fitting for the police and firemen. Cantigny's auxiliary does a lot for this post. These women and men work hard. They're here constantly. It's mainly during fish fry, during Lent. We serve a lot of fish, if you're interested, 4 to 7:30. And tonight, the president of the auxiliary, Donna Redman, is here. The treasurer of the auxiliary, Betsy Denna Willis, is here. They work hard, trust me. Now, I know there's a lot of you out here, men and women, who are veterans. Could you please stand up? Veterans, please stand up. We want to welcome you home, and hopefully you'll join our post. Society owes you a debt. Personally, as a citizen of Joliet, I'm a big promoter of the men in blue. I'm all for law and order, and I'm all for the fire department, of course, and the dangers that each one of them do every day. And I know the ladies wondered, are you gonna come home tonight? Trust me, a lot of citizens know that, and we appreciate all of you. Thank you. Okay, I'm going to turn it over to Jim Clausen. He's our adjutant and quartermaster to present the awards tonight. Thank you.
Thank you, Lou. Okay, and I am Jim Clausen. I am the quartermaster of Cantigny Post 367, also the quartermaster of the 18th District of the VFW. And in September of 2001, I was the post commander. So since then, it's always been an honor for me to present these awards to our really outstanding first responders here in Joliet, who are outstanding not only here, but also in the whole state. I mean, they've received recognition from, you know, on the state level, both the VFW and the state legislature. So with I like to keep things short and simple. So without further ado, we'd like to present the award to the Police Officer of the Year. So I'd like to ask Chief Evans to please come up.
Good afternoon. My name is Bill Evans. I'm the chief here in Joliet for the Police Department. I just want to take this opportunity to personally congratulate Ken on this prestigious award. I'd also like to thank the VFW for the continued support of not only the JPD officers, but first responders all over. Last year, Ken effected over 100 arrests responding to 664 calls for service. Ken also logged 19 DUIs during that year and frequently assisted other officers during their calls. While we have several great officers here in Joliet, Ken's achievements and accomplishments day in and day out during the 2022 year stand alone. Ken, without any further ado, I'd like to tell you that the city of Joliet is proud of you, your family is proud of you, the police department is proud of you, and I'm proud of you. Thank you, and once again, congratulations.
Good evening. I just wanted to read off real quick the nomination that we submitted for Officer Masiak. Officer Masiak was assigned to Sector 22 and responded to 664 calls for service. He made 9 felony arrests and 100 misdemeanor arrests. He also issued 361 traffic citations, 355 parking tickets. He completed 34 FI field interview cards, and he also issued 12 compliance tickets. He's a field training officer, and he spent approximately 24 weeks during 2022 riding with a recruit officer. Officer Masiak has placed an emphasis on enforcing DUI offenders. On his own and with recruits, he made over 19 DUI arrests in 2022. Officer Masiak is extremely knowledgeable in DUI enforcement and is always eager to assist other officers when they need assistance with the DUI arrests. He frequently assists other officers with that completion of field sobriety tests. One final thing is I was Officer Masiak's supervisor for the year of 2022, and the officers all loved Officer Masiak. We have a huge influx of new officers in Joliet. We've hired over 60 officers over the past 2 years, and he is by far one of the FTOs that all the new officers love going with. They know they're gonna work when they ride with them. They know they're going to get involved in things. They know they're going to be doing felony arrests. They know they're going to get a DUI. They know this is somebody that is going to get them involved in work and is going to show them how the right way to be a police officer. I've heard this from the new officers, that they appreciate the work he does. I know myself and the other supervisors that supervise them appreciate the work he does. And the citizens who have worked with him, they've said this also. So without further ado, definitely want to say congratulations to Officer Masiak.
I have a citation that says, Veterans of Foreign Wars of the United States Certificate of Appreciation awarded to Officer Kenneth Masiak, Joliet Police Department, in grateful recognition of unyielding adherence to the highest ideals of law enforcement in maintaining, preserving, and protecting the lawful rights of all citizens. And it's signed by Lou Smith and myself.
Congratulations.
First of all, I'd like to thank everyone for coming tonight, taking time out of your own schedule. I'd like to thank the VFW post here, as well as the auxiliary. I really appreciate, again, the support from the police department. I'd like to thank my chief and the command staff, as well as my watch commanders, and Sergeant Zeta Grin for putting me in for this prestigious award. It's truly an honor to serve and protect the people of Joliet and come to work every day. It's truly an adventure and a great honor every day. I appreciate it. Thank you.
And Chief Evans, can you step up here for a minute? Because we always make donations to the police department, so I have a $100 check from the Cantigny Post, and also a check from the auxiliary. And
thank
to
you
do
so much.
Whatever benefits
thank
the,
you.
The police department.
And we do a lot of it. Thank
okay,
you.
Thank you. So next, I'd like to present a citation to the our firefighter of the year. So I'd like Chief Carey, please step up.
Thank you.
Thank you, everybody. Most of all, thank the VFW for hosting this wonderful event every year. I know the firefighter and police officers look forward to it for recognizing their hard work all year. Congratulations to the police officer and firefighter of the year. You guys deserve it. Great job. And all the rest of the firefighter and police officers in this room that do that work every day. I'd also like to recognize the mayor, city council, and city manager. I know everybody pointed you guys out already, but I also want to recognize city manager Jim Caparelli. The program we're about to talk about, what the Firefighter of the Year award was about this year, is all about community, just like you guys with your community. That's what we've started really doing with outreach and community events. And the guy who got the Fire for the Year award this night really has exemplified what that means to community. But we couldn't have did any of this I'm about to talk about without the support that we get from the city manager, mayor, and council. So thank you guys for your support of the services we provide. I'm gonna read the nomination letter that I received for the Fire for the Year. To whom it may concern, I would like to nominate Battalion Chief John Cook for the VFW Firefighter of the Year. I think he is worthy of this award, not for a single event, but rather his commitment to the community of Joliet over the past 8 months. First, some background on his position. In 2022, the City Council agreed to staff a Battalion Chief of Community Risk Reduction. This is a new idea in the fire service. There are many departments that have no idea what CRR even is. Other departments view CRR as handing out smoke detectors. At the Joliet Fire Department, we take a more innovative view of how to fix the biggest problems in our community and help find ways to make our community more resilient. BC Cook took a big risk by taking the BC of CRR position. His job is to do things that firefighters traditionally do not do. He is trying to improve citizens' quality of life before an emergency happens. Building off of the crisis first aid and mental health success the JFD has already had, BC Cook continues to build a whole new way to improve the quality of life of our citizens in Joliet. There's a myriad of examples that I could choose from, but there's two that stand out. First is a 3-year-old who was having severe behavioral issues due to abuse. He is a foster child and behavior was beyond the ability of foster parents to manage. The child was in danger of becoming a ward of the state when BC Cook got the call about him. He used the JFD's mental health connections to contact a specialist from Chicago to see the child personally every week in Joliet. Because of these actions, the child will have a chance at a normal life. With therapy, the child is improving. Without BC Cook's actions as the CRR battalion chief, this child most likely would have ended up institutionalized or incarcerated. The second example is a person who was homeless and a drug addict. Using resources that Chief Cook has developed to get this person into rehab, the person has been clean since rehab now, he's got a job, and living in a rental apartment. BC Cook had many after-hour conversations and text threads with him to help get him through this process. This is an example of very well could be the Joliet model to help our homeless succeed in Joliet. BC Cook took a risk in taking the position because it is not what firefighters normally do. I had many conversations with him and he wondered if he did the right thing because he didn't feel like a firefighter anymore. I kept telling him he was saving lives just in a different way. Because of the concept of community risk reduction is new to the fire service, in many ways, B.C. Cook is leading the state of how to fix some of the community's most troubling issues. These are the reasons I think B.C. Cook is worthy of VFW Firefighter of the Year. Respectfully submitted, Battalion Chief Aaron Kozlowski. I couldn't agree with that more. He pretty much summed up the whole thing. And that is just a snippet of what has happened. I think one of the most important things is 8 months ago, this position didn't even exist. It wasn't even a thing in Joliet. And 8 months later, we've got so much demand coming into his office for people in the community that need these services that we can't even keep up. So the tremendous job he's done is just made more work for himself, but the amount of people he's helped in the community is more than we could have ever imagined. I know it's not he doesn't do the regular 9-to-5, just like we said. He gets calls after hours from the people he's helping, gets calls on the weekends, never turns them down. If he was just taking this as a 9-to-5 job, none of this would ever happen. So I believe all that above and beyond that you've gone, this program would have never succeeded to the amount that it has without your hard work and dedication. So if you guys would join me in welcoming the Joliet Fire Department VFW Fire for the Year, Battalion Chief John Cook.
Actually, I have two certificates to award to Battalion Chief Cook. First, Veterans of Foreign Wars of the United States Certificate of Appreciation award to Battalion Chief John Cook, Joliet Fire Department. And special recognition and highest praise for alertness, personal courage, and every efficient guardianship of life and property. And signed by Lou Smith and myself. And also, I have a certificate from the State of Illinois, 103rd General Assembly, House of Representatives. It acknowledges John Cook, Battalion Chief of Community Risk Reduction, in recognition of being recognized by Cantigny Post 367, Veterans of Foreign Wars and its Ladies Auxiliary, as Firefighter of the Year for his exceptional service to Joliet Fire Department and to the greater community, given March 2023, offered by Representative Larry Walsh Jr. and Natalie Manley.
Thank you very much. This thing's almost taller than me. Well, hello, everybody. I'd like to thank the VFW for supporting this and having this event for us every year. The Ladies Auxiliary, we know they're probably really in charge and running the show for us. Thank you for getting it going. I'd like to thank the manager, the mayor, and the city council as well. They took a big chance on Chief Carey's idea. Like they said, this really is not happening in the fire service. There's a few fire departments out there saying they're doing it. We made some calls to get some insights and found out some are kind of sort of doing it, but not really. Well, now they're calling us to find out what we're doing and how we're making it happen. And I'm going to tell you what I tell them in just a minute. I'd like to take another second to thank Chief Carey for giving me a lot of rope to hang myself by. He's not afraid to listen to me. I know going with some crazy ideas once in a while. The good part, though, is he listens. And he's not afraid to try, which I think is another reason this program is a success. I want to thank the on-duty and off-duty brothers and sisters from the JFD. Thank you for coming out here and supporting the fire department tonight, and for the tremendous amount of work you guys are doing to make this program a success. And my family, my parents, John and Karen Cook, are here. My children, Jared, Jacob, and Olivia, and my wife, Brenda. They all had things going on tonight. They had to work and such, and they changed their schedules to be here. It makes me feel very good. Thank you. You know, the fire department says we are a team. We do team activities. We are a team sport. And it is so true. We don't do anything alone. It could be an ambulance crew treating somebody who's ill. It could be an entire company treating somebody who's having a heart attack or a seizure or a stroke. It could be multiple companies searching a house that's on fire for a victim, pulling hose lines to get to the fire. It could be multiple companies who are doing a vehicle extrication while paramedics are in the car treating their injuries. And we're all depending on each other to do our jobs with the goal of making a positive outcome in the life of that person. And we can't do it if we don't do it together. Well, the Community Risk Reduction Division is not different. It is not a solo act. In fact, it's really the on-duty and off-duty crews who are carrying out an abundance, if not a majority, of the public education the fire inspections, the prevention measures, and the outreach programs. They are the ones who have a daily interaction with our people, and they're finding out what's going on out there. I noticed since Chief Carey got us, all our guys to critical or crisis first aid training, they're treating their people so different, and they're listening, and they're finding out what's going on. But not just the patients, the people around them, the bystanders that might have saw something bad happen, their family and their friends. They're really reaching out. They know what's going on. When I came in this office in July, I started hearing getting phone calls, emails, and having people stop me in the public and say, thank you. Your crews are paying attention to me. They're treating me like a human being. They're treating me with respect and dignity. That alone is improving the quality of life because they might not get that on a daily basis. So awesome job. You guys are finding people who need help, and like I tell you every morning, I almost want to say stop, there's too much work. But really, you guys aren't just filing paperwork and looking for help. I've got countless examples of where you guys are stepping up and doing something. I want to give just a couple. I know of two or three ambulance crews that if they go to someone's house and they won't go to the hospital, they'll take time to stay and make them lunch or make them dinner. Imagine that. Think about that. That is way outside of the fire service. How cool is that? I know of a few other crews that have gone to residents and they've noticed that these people probably don't have enough food and their children aren't dressed appropriately, at least for the weather. They've pooled their money together and they've gone grocery shopping and clothes shopping and they've delivered that to those families. Amazing. Amazing. Just recently, the beginning of this week, Big Brothers Big Sisters reached out to me. They got a lot of kids, right? But they got a kid who's having some trouble and needs a mentor and loves firefighters. Can you help? I said, well, it's nothing we've ever done before. You're gonna have to give me time. And I hung up the phone. I got details, I hung up the phone. I said, well, how am I gonna word this? I just worded it like she said to me, and I thought, all right, this is big, and it's new, and new is scary, so nobody wants to be part of new because it's scary, and our guys are busy. I sent out the email. In an hour, I had five people call me, text me, and email and say, I'm in, what can I do? How do I do this? At the start of the next day, it was nine people. I saw some emails saying, I have a chance to read, but it looks like there's another four or five. That is awesome. How amazing is that? And that's you guys doing that. And those are just a few of the examples. So when the departments ask me how this is working, what I tell them is we have a city manager, a city council, a mayor who supports us. We have a chief who supports us, wants to see the community thrive, and lets us do what we need to do. And most importantly, the crews are buying in, and they're the ones carrying out the work. You guys are doing a job. Keep it up. It's good. That's enough of me talking. We need a beer. Let's go have some fun.
Chief Carey. So, Donna, I have a check here. It's a $100 donation to the Joliet Fire Department, and also Donna has one from the auxiliary.
Auxiliary for $100.
For $100. Thank you. And you can do it wherever Joliet Fire Department really needs it.
Thank you. Thank you.
Congratulations to the Policeman and Fireman of the Year. This concludes our program. We have complimentary cookies in the back. We have pop and water downstairs. For anybody that wants, the bar is open downstairs if you want to go to the bar. All right, thank you all for coming. See you next year.